Now in part 8 video, we are going to continue the new exercise 1.3. In 1.3 exercise, we are having 9 problems. Clear? The first problem is match the following. So that match the following you are going to do as homework. Now I am going to start with second question. Which of the following properties hold for subtraction of rational numbers? Why? They have given the properties, some of the properties they have given. What are the properties? Closure, commutative, associative, identity, inverse. We are going to check these 5 properties is true for subtraction. We are going to check. Clear all of you the question? First, we will take the closure property. See, closure property for subtraction, what is the property? A minus B. Since we have given subtraction for all the property, we have used only subtraction. See, I have used subtraction A minus B. You have to take any value for A and similarly you can take any value for B. Here I have taken A value is 8 by 3 and B value I have taken 4 by 3. Clear? So now here both the denominators are same. I have written 1, 3. The numerator you have to subtract, isn't it? 8 minus 4 is what? 4. So 4 by 3. Can tell you? 4 by 3 is a rational number or not? Yes, it is a rational number. So closure property is true, you have to write. Clear all of you? The next property we are going to solve, commutative property. What is the commutative property for subtraction? Subtraction only you have to say. Subtraction means, in commutative property for addition we have seen here plus. But subtraction means minus you have to write. Commutative means A minus B is equal to B minus A. The reverse you have to write. Clear students? For this A higher. Students, for all the problems you can take any value for A. Any rational numbers you can take. Similarly you can take any rational numbers for B. And any rational number for C you can take. Here I have taken A is 9 by 2, B is 3 by 2, equal to I have written. 3 what value I have taken? 3 by 2 minus A. A is 9 by 2. Clear? We know before itself, in previous part 6 video itself I have gave on notes. No, in that itself I have told you A minus B is not equal to B minus A I have given you. Isn't it? So we know. So now we are going to start. Now, A value is 9 by 2, B value is 3 by 2 is not equal to 3 by 2 minus 9 by 2. Now, there are two denominators, so write 1, 2. 9 minus 3 numerator. Here 3 minus 9 divided by 2. 9 minus 3 answer is what? 6 divided by 2. This side 3 minus 9 is what? Minus 6 by 2. Now, if you cancel, 2 table 6 will go, isn't it? How many times? 3 times. Here how many times? 3 times. So you are getting minus 3. Here students, all of you. So in one equation you should not supposed to get 2 equal to. So I am writing here implies. Clear? Now whether 3 is equal to minus 3? No. I have told you before itself minus 3 will be in the left side of the 0 and positive 3 will be in the right side of the 0. So this both are not equal. So commutative property fails. You have to write. Clear? The next C is associative property. Associative property for subtraction is what? A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. Clear? Associative property for subtraction, it is not true. We know before itself, in tabular column itself I have told you. But anyhow, now we will try with some rational numbers. Here I am going to take the 4, 3. I am not going to take fractions. I am going to take the only one natural number I am going to take here. So now if you see, I have taken A as 4, B as 3 and C as 6. Clear? So here A value we know 4, B value is 3, C value is 6. So 4 minus 3 is what? 1 minus 6 is not equal to this 4 I have written. Minus here 3 minus 6 is what? Minus 3. So now 1 minus 6 is not equal to minus minus next step it has become positive 4 plus 3. So this side we are getting answer minus 5. This side we are getting positive 7. Whether these two are equal? No, it is not equal. Therefore, associative property also fails. Students, for associative property, you can give rational numbers. Fraction form also if you are giving, you will not get equal. There also you will get associative property fails only. The last one is, last before is identity. Identity property means, I have told you, identity means what? The number if you are taking, 2 means you have to get the answer also the same 2. So identity for addition is plus 0. If you add 2 plus 0 is what? 2. Similarly, for multiplication, what do you have to get? You have to multiply with 2. For subtraction means 2 minus 0, you have to get the same 2, isn't it? Whether 2 minus 0 equal to 2. But 0 minus 2 if you are applying, whether you will get 2? No, you will get minus 2. So, identity property also fails. Clear all of you? Your A value I have taken 7. Minus 0 is not equal to 0 minus 7. 7 minus 0 is 7. 0 minus 7 is minus 7. Identity property also fails. Likewise, inverse also fails for subtraction. Clear, students, all of you? Students, you are going to take values for A, B, C. Your wish, you can take any number. But you have to say whether commutative property, associative property, closure property, identity property, inverse property is true for subtraction. We are going to check. Clear? Next, we will see the third question. Now, we are going to see the third question. See the question. Subbu spends 1 by 3 of his monthly year earnings on rent. 2 by 5. Clear? Clear students. Subbu spends 1 by 3 of his monthly earning on rent. 2 by 5 on food. And 1 by 10 on monthly usuals. Monthly usual means other things. Okay? What fractional part of his earning left with him for other expenses? Clear all of you? One man is earning some amount, we don't know that amount, but from the amount he is spending 1 by 3 part for his rent. See, now suppose consider this is the total amount. Clear? So from this total he is taking one part for rent. I have written capital R. Can you able to see me? Capital R for one portion is taking for rent. And another portion, the 2 by 5 of the fraction is taking for food. Next, 1 by 10 is taking for monthly usuals. So, we are spending for remaining purpose. So, now you see the circle, this much part you have spent. Now, what is the remaining? This part we don't know, isn't it? From the total, this much he has spent, remaining part we don't know. That part we are going to find now. Clear, students? Clear, all of you? Now, how many part you have spent for rent 1 by 3, for food 2 by 5, monthly usuals he has taken 1 by 10. So, first, all together, if you add what we have to get in, first we have to find. Clear? Suppose you think, I will give you an example. Your mother is giving 100 rupees. Okay? You are taking to the shop. You are buying one toys. The cost of the toys is 20. Next, you are spending for ice cream. The cost of the ice cream is 30. Next, you are buying other material. Anything, any material, suppose if you are buying means, for that you are spending 30. So, how much you have spent then? 20, 30, 30. So, remaining amount, what amount you will have in your hand? Out of 100, you have spent 20, 30, 30 rupees. So, 20 plus 30 is what? 50. 50 plus 30 is what? 80. You have spent 80 rupees and in your hand you are having now 20 rupees. How we are saying? From the total, we have to take this part. Only then we will get the remaining. Isn't it? The same process we are going to do here. Students, all of you able to understand the question? Now we will go for the solution. So, total spending of Subbu. So, 1 by 3 is spent for rent. 2 by 5 is spent for food and 1 by 10 is spent for monthly usuals. So first we have to add all the three. See here, all the denominators are different. So we have to take LCM for 3, 5 and 10. Yes, we are getting the answer is 30. Clear? So you have to get denominator as 30. So what we are going to do? We are going to multiply with 10 and 10, numerator and denominator. Plus here 5, you have to make it 30, means you have to multiply with 6, numerator and denominator. Here 10 we are having. So we have to get 30, means we have to multiply numerator and denominator with 3. Clear? See, I have done the LCM this side. Clear? Since I don't have space, that's it, I have done here. But you have to write in the right side of your column. Now you see, 1 into 10 is 10, 3 into 10 is 30, plus 2 into 6 is 12, 5 into 6 is 30, 1 into 3 is 3, plus 10 into 3 is 30. Now see, all the denominators are same. Now we have to just add the numerator, isn't it? 10 plus 12 plus 3. 10 plus 12 plus 3 divided by 30 is equal to 10 plus 12 is what? 22. 22 plus 3 is what? 25 divided by 30. 25 and 30 will go in same table, isn't it? What table? 5 table it will go. So if you are cancelling 25 and 5 table, it will come 5 times. 30 it will come 6 times. So how much fraction you have spent? 5 by 6 of you have spent in the total amount. But we don't know what is the total earning. So we are taking the total earning as 1. Here the total earning we are taking as 1. So now fractions of money left with Subbu. So how much fraction is having we are going to find. See, the total we have taken here is 1. The spended amount we have found is 5 by 6. Clear all of you? Now see here 1 only is the denominator part we are having. I have told you many times, if denominator is not there, you have to take it as denominator 1. Isn't it? So then what we have to do? We have to do the cross multiplication. 1 into 6 minus 1 into 5 divided by 1 into 6. Clear how I am doing the cross multiplication? 1 into 6 minus 1 into 5 divided by 1 6 are 6. So 1 6 are 6, 1 5 are 5. In between minus, so write minus. Divided by 6. So 6 minus 5 divided by 6 is what? 6 minus 5 is what? 1. So the answer is 1 divided by 6 is the fraction amount left with Subbu. Students, clear all of you? The same model, the fourth question, you are going to do as homework. Finally, in the assignment column, I will write the question. Now, next we are going to see the third question. Now, we are going to see the fifth question. See, this question is interesting question. See the question. If 3 by 4 of a box of apples weigh 3 kg and 225 gram. How much does a full box of apple weigh? Clear all of you? Can you able to understand the question? What? See students, now consider this is the apple box. So 3 by 4 of the portion. So among the full box, the 3 by portion of the apple contains how many kilogram means? 3 kilogram, 225 gram. Okay, up to this apple the kg is 3 kilogram, 225 gram. In the question they were asking how much does a full box of apple weigh. So full box, the weight of the apple they were asking. Clear? See, I have taken box one side and kilogram and gram I have taken another side. See, 3 by 4 part of the apple contains how many weight? 3 kilogram, 225 gram, isn't it? So for 3 by 4 of the fraction, we are having 3 kilogram, 225 gram. Clear? Now in question, they were asking full box weight, isn't it? in third question itself I told you I have drawn one circle. I have told you the full salary. The full salary we have to consider as 1. Similarly, the full box, this we are considering the old as 1. Okay, the old part we don't know, so that we are taking as 1. The same only we have did in third question also. The old part we have taken as 1. Similarly, in fifth question also, we are taking the old part as 1. When the full box is old part, we are taking 1. We don't know the weight. That only we have to find, isn't it? So, I have written x. Since we don't know the kilogram of the full box, I have written x. Clear all of you? Some portion of the box, we have given the weight as 3 kg 225 g. The portion fraction is 3/4. They are asking full old portion of the box. So old means you have to take as 1. We have to find the old box weight. We don't know, so I have taken x. Students, clear all of you the question? Now we'll start the solution. What I am going to do is I am going to do the cross multiplication here. 3/4 × x. 3/4 × x is nothing but what? X will go to numerator. So, I have written 3x/4 is equal to this side. I am doing the cross multiplication. 1 × 3 kg, 225 g. Clear? But there I have written 3000 g + 225 g. Why I am writing like this means, see, you can convert kilogram into gram, or else you can convert this gram into kilogram. You can make it in any ways. But for us, this we want, this is kilogram, this is gram. Now see, 1 kilogram is equal to how many gram? 1000 gram. 1 kg equal to 1000 gram. Then 1 means here 1000. 3 means what we will get? 3000 gram. Isn't it? So that is easy. So I am making here both the things into gram. Clear? First we have cross multiplied. 3x/4 is equal to 3 kilogram. How we can write 3 kilogram? Kilogram only we want to convert into gram, isn't it? So 3 kilogram means how many gram? 3000 gram. So 3 kilogram instead of that I have written 3000 gram. So the second part, 225 g, that is already in gram. So write that 225 gram itself. Clear all of you? Clear? The next step, 3000 g + 225 g is what? 3225 g. Here in denominator we are having 4. Take this 4 to this side, which means it will become multiplication. Into 4 it will become. Okay, so next step we are cancelling 3, and next step it is 3 will come down to the denominator. Isn't it? 2x is equal to 6 means 6x is equal to what you will write? 6/2. No, the same concept only. We are bringing the 3 down. Next step, 325 × 4/3. 3 and 3225 will get cancelled. Clear all of you? 3 and 3225 will go in same table. In 3 table, 3 1 times, 3225 will come 1075 times. Clear students? So 1075 × 4, if you multiply, we are getting 4300 g. Clear? In question, how they have given the value? One part is kilogram and another part we have given in gram. So likewise, same you have to write the final answer also. See, here 4 we are having, which means how many kilogram we are having? 4 kilogram. Remaining you have to take as 300 gram. If you add this, what you will get the remaining 4300 gram only. Students, all of you are clear? This is very very simple still. Clear? We are just cross multiplying and we are converting the kilogram into gram. Afterwards we are adding. After adding we are bringing this 4 to this side and we are taking the 3 to the down. Clear? Next step we are cancelling and we are writing 4 kilogram and 300 gram. That's it. Next we will see the 6th question. Students, next we are going to see the 6th question. Mangalam buys a water jug of capacity 3 4 by 3 liters. Clear? one lady. The lady name is Mangalam. He is buying a jug. Okay, see, I have drawn a jug. The capacity of the jug is, the first, this is the smaller jug. The capacity of the jug is 3 4 by 3 liters. Okay, if she buys another jug which is 2 2 by 3 times as larger as the smaller jug. Clear? She is buying the another jug which is 2 2 by 3 times larger than the smaller jug. Clear? Now she is buying another jug which is bigger size than the first one. How many liters can the larger one hold? So in this big jug, how many liter we can pour, we have to find. Clear all of you? Roughly clear about the question? Shall we go for the now answer? Yes, solution. Smaller jug, how much capacity it will hold? 3 4 by 5 liters. They have given in what fraction? Mixed fraction they have given. Clear? Now, next, smaller jug capacity is 3 4 by 3 liters. Bigger jug, which means larger jug, is equal to what they have given? 2 2 by 3 times as smaller jug. So, 2 2 by 3 times. Times means into. Times means what? Multiply. Into. Wherever you are seeing times word, 2 times of 5. 5 times of 2 becoming means, which means what? 2 into 5. 5 into 2, like that. Times means you have to do multiply. 2 by 3 times of smaller jug. So in next step, if you see 2 2 by 3, times means what I told, multiply. I have written here multiply. Smaller jug. Smaller jug is what? 3 4 by 5. Clear all of you? 3 4 by 5. Now, this, the smaller jug also is in mixed fraction. The larger jug is also in mixed fraction. So, both the things we have to convert into improper fraction. First, we will see. 2, 3, so 2 into 3 plus 2 divided by 3. 3 into 5 plus 4 divided by 5. What answer you will get? 2 into 3 plus 2 divided by 3. What answer you will get? You will get 6 plus 2 divided by 3 into, that side you are getting 15 plus 4 divided by 5. 6 plus 2 is 8 by 3. 15 plus 4 is what? 16, 17, 18, 19. 19 by 5. Clear? Now afterwards you have to multiply 8 into 19. You have to see first, before anything is getting cancelled. Nothing is getting cancelled. So directly numerator you have to multiply. Denominator you have to multiply. So 8 into 19 answer is 152. Clear? Similarly 3 into 5 is 15. How they have given the question in mixed fraction? The same form we have also have to give the answer in the mixed fraction. So for that I am dividing 152 with 15. Clear? Now how many times 15 will come? First I am taking 115. 115s are 15. Next I am bringing this 2 down. So by that time I have to add 1 0, then only I have to bring. Because 15 2 will not go, no? So you have to write 0, then only you have to bring the 2. Now how we are going to write, how, if you want to write in mixed fraction, means how we have to write quotient, reminder, divided by divisor. In the this form only you have to write. In the pencil side you write this and keep. So that for future when you are reading for the exam or test, you will be feel easy. So how we have to write quotient, reminder, divided by divisor. Quotient is 10, reminder is 2. Divisor is 15. So see the same order I have written. Quotient is 10. I have written 10. Then remainder is what? 2. I have written 2 divided by divisor. Divisor is 15. I have written 15. So this largest jug holds how many liter? 10 2 by 15 liter it will hold when compared to the smaller one. Clear students, all of you? Clear all of you? Next we will see the 7th question.
Now we are going to see 7th question.
In a recipe, making every 1 1/2 cup of rice requires 2 3/4 cups of water. Express this in the ratio of rice to water we want to express. Can you able to understand the question? Can you able to understand? Okay, I'll explain now. In a recipe, we are going to make one dish. For that dish, okay, we are taking 1 1/2 cup of rice, means 1 1/2 cup of rice they were taking. Okay, for that, how much water we required is 2 3/4 cup of water we need. Okay, so they were asking that the water and the rice, they were asking us to express in the ratio. Ratio means by, divide. Divide form you have to write. Clear? They have given what? Ratio. So this answer divided by that answer you are doing. What answer you are getting? That is the ratio of rice and water. Clear? That only I have written. Ratio means what? By. Divide by. So how we will denote? 2 dot we will keep. Ratio means 2 dot we will keep. Rice is to water. For which they were asking the ratio? For rice and water we are going to find the ratio. For rice we have given 1 1/2 cup. What for that 1 1/2 cup, how much water we required? 2 3/4 of water we required. That only they have given in the question. Now this is a mixed fraction. We want to convert into improper fraction. Similarly, this is also in mixed fraction. We want to convert into improper fraction. See, 1 into 2 plus 1 divided by 2. In between ratio sign. 2 into 4 plus 3 divided by 4. Now, you see 1 into 2 is 2 plus 1 divided by 2. Ratio 4 2s are 8 plus 3 divided by 4. Now, we have got 3/2 ratio 11 by 4. I have told you the ratio means by. Now I am writing in the by form. See, 3/2 by, this is the middle part, divided by 11/4. Okay, students, see, so far we have seen 3/2, like this fraction only we have seen, isn't it? Now see, in the numerator part we are having one fraction and the denominator part again we are having one fraction. Which means, like this, if it's coming, means 4. For division, if you are getting 4 values, means what you are going to do is the denominator part, what you have to make it reciprocal. The denominator part you have to make it reciprocal. Reciprocal means this 4 will go up, this 11 will come down. Which means the denominator will go up, the numerator will come down. That is the reciprocal. By that time, this divide line will become into multiply. Clear? Nothing but you have to write this 3/2 as such. This 11/4 you have to do reciprocal. Reciprocal means 4/11 you have to write. Clear? Then now see, anything is getting cancelled? Yes. 2 and 4 will get cancelled. 2 table, how many times 4? 2 times. So here 1, here 2. 3 2s are 6, 1 11s are 11. So now in what by form we have got? 6 divided by 11. So the ratio of rice is 6 and the ratio of water is 11. So from this what they were saying? 6 cup of rice requires 11 cup of water. Can you able to understand? Therefore you have to write the last line. The ratio of rice to water is 6 is to 11. Clear? This is very very simple problem. Understand, student? Next, we will see the 8th question. Students, now we will see the 8th question. Ravi multiplied 25 by 8 and 16 by 15 to obtain 400 divided by 120. He says that the simplest form of this product is 10 by 3. Okay, up to this what they were saying in the question, Ravi is taking two rational numbers. One is 25 by 18 and 16 by 15 he is taking, and he is multiplying the two rational numbers. Clear? By that time, is getting the answer as 400 divided by 120 is getting. Then that answer is making into simplest form. Simplest form means cancelling. Okay, cancelling both the numerator and denominator, cancelling in 2 table, 3 table or 5 table. Likewise, he is cancelling. After cancelling, he brought the answer as 10 by 3. Clear? And another boy, Chandru, says the answer in the simplest form is 3 1 by 3. Clear? Chandru is saying the simplest form of 400 divided by 120 is 10 by 3. But Ravi is saying the 400 divided by 120 simplest form is 10 by 3. And Chandru is saying 400 divided by 120 simplest form is 3 1 by 3. Clear? We have to find who is correct. Either Ravi or Chandru is correct, we have to find. Clear? First we'll go for the solution. Ravi, what are the two numbers we have multiplied? We multiply 25 by 8 into 16 by 15, he multiplied. When he multiplying, what answer he got? He got the answer as 400 divided by 120 he has got. Next, this answer what he did? He has cancelled. He had made into simplest form. Simplest form means he has cancelled. Okay, now I'll show you how he cancelled. See, 0, 0 cancel, 40 divided by 12. Both will go in 4 table, isn't it? In 4 table, 40 10 times. In 4 table, 12, 3 times. So, Ravi answered what he has got 10 by 3. Clear? Now, this 10 by 3, if you divide 10 with 3, so what you will get? See, I have done here. 3 3s are 9. So 10 minus 9 is 1. So I have told you we have to write in the mixed fraction, because Chandru answer is a mixed fraction. No, we will convert Ravi answer also in mixed fraction. See how in mixed fraction we have to write. I have told you in 7th problem, isn't it? Quotient, remainder by divisor. See what is the quotient? 3. So I have written 3. Remainder is 1. I have written here 1. Divisor is what? 3. So 3 1 by 3 is the simplest form of Ravi. Clear? What is the Chandru simplest form they have given? This answer is also 3 1 by 3. See, Chandru simplest form equal to 3 1 by 3. Clear? Therefore, we can conclude that Ravi and Chandru both are correct. Because what? Ravi's simplest form also we are getting 3 1 by 3, and Chandru's simplest form also we are getting 3 1 by 3. So finally we can say that Ravi and Chandru both are correct. Next we will see the next question. Now we are going to see the 10th question. Find the length of a room whose area is 153 by 10 square meter and whose breadth is 2 large by 20 meter. Students, can you able to understand the question? The length of the room we have to find, but the whole area they have given and the breadth also they have given. Okay, length and breadth comes means in what shape the room is in? Can you tell me? Yes, the room is in rectangle shape. So area of the rectangle formula is what? We all know area of the rectangle is L into B. L is nothing but length into B is nothing but breadth. Clear? Here we don't know the length. Okay, so I am keeping the length as L. Breadth B. They are given value is 211 by 20. How will you convert this 211 by 20 is mixed fraction? How will you convert into this improper fraction? 2 into 20 you have to multiply. So for previous problem I have done, no, improper fraction we have converted mixed fraction into improper fraction, isn't it? So 2 into 20 is 40 plus 11. 40 plus 11 is what? 51 divided by 20 is our improper fraction. And in question they have given area of the room is 153 divided by 10 square meter. They are given. Clear? With using this two, we have to find the length L. Clear, students? We know area of a room. The room is in rectangle shape. So area of the rectangle formula here we will apply. What is that? Length into breadth. So total area of the room they have given. 153 divided by 10, they have given the question itself. Length we don't know, so keep L itself. Breadth we have converted into improper fraction. What is that? 51 divided by 20. Students, you see, here 153 divided by 10 we are having. Here L into one number we are having. Isn't it? So like this, I will give you one example in what format that is there. See, suppose if you are having 2x is equal to 4, but you need to find the value of x, means how you will write x is equal to 4, this 2 will come down, isn't it? 4 divided by 2 you will write, no, the same format only here also we are having. 153 divided by 10, this 51 divided by 20, what it will come? Divide form. So whole divided by 51 divided by 20. Clear all of you? This is for your understanding I have written. This is not in the part of the question. Clear? Now you see here we, in numerator we are having one fraction, in denominator we are having one fraction. I have told you in previous problem. Isn't it? What? For numerator one fraction, for denominator you are having one fraction, means the denominator part it will become into reciprocal. Reciprocal means it will convert, this 20 will go up, this 51 will come down. See, 153 divided by 10, this divide will become into multiply, then 51 divided by 20 will become reciprocal. 20 divided by 51 is equal to L. 10 and 20 if you cancel here 2 times, 10 1 times. 51 if you divide with 153, I am getting as 3. 3 into 51 is 153, so we have got remainder 0. So 3 into 2 is 6 meter. So length is what? Length of the room is what? 6 meter. Therefore you have to write the last line. The length of the room is 6 meter. Clear, students? With this, our chapter 1 rational number is over. Next you will get the homework problem. Students, this is your part 8 assignment. In part 8 you are going to do 3 problems. The first question is match the following. In exercise 1.3, first question you are going to do, then 4th question and 9th question. These are the problems you are going to do from exercise 1.3. Clear? Now I am going to explain the question. In a constituency, 19 divided by 25 of the voter had voted for candidate A. See, for candidate A, how much of them have voted? 19 divided by 25. For candidate B, how much of them have voted? 7 divided by 50. Find the rational number of the voter who had voted for others. See, like 4th problem where we have done another problem in exercise 1.3. Yes, very good. We have done the same model in 3rd question, isn't it? So you refer the 3rd question, then you start doing the 4th question. Okay, now this 2 part they are occupied in the old part, isn't it? So first you have to find this 2 part. How we will find? We will add this 2, 19 divided by 25 plus 7 divided by 50, you are going to add first. Okay, clear all of you? See, like this you are going to add 19 divided by 25 plus 7 divided by 50. For 25 and 50 are different denominators, so make the denominator same. After making the denominator same, how will you make the denominator same? By taking LCM. Afterwards you can directly add the numerator. Okay, keep that value as such. Next, this after adding this 2 part, you are going to subtract with the old. Isn't it? Old means like what I have told you, it is 1. So the old with the old part, we are going to subtract the 2 A and B answer. So now what I have written in the down, you see,
First find this 1, which means what? For your understanding I have written. So now what value you have got, that value you are going to subtract with 1 minus that answer you are going to write here. Clear? You, if you refer third question, means you will feel very clear. Clear? After subtracting, what answer, rational number you are getting, that is the answer for fourth question. Clear? Next we will see the ninth question. A piece of wire is 4 by 5 meter long. So, see, this is the piece of wire which is 4 by 5 meter long. It is cut into 8 pieces. 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It has cut into 8 pieces. How long each piece is be? Okay, this piece length, this piece length, this piece length, this piece length, every piece length, how long we have to find. Clear? But each piece has in the same length only they are telling. So, one piece is equal to, which means what? Total piece length is what? 4 by 5 meter. How many pieces we are going to cut that total length? 8 pieces we are going to cut. Students, see a cut, if the word comes itself, immediately are going to divide. So, 4 by 5 divided by 8. See, for 8 we don't have denominator, considered as 1. I have told you in division, if you are having 4 numbers, the numerator part you are going to write as such. The denom, this divided, it will become into multiply. 8 by 1, it will become into 1 by 8. Now cancel this 4 and 8. Then 1 divided by 2 you will get. So multiply the numerator and multiply the denominator. That is your answer. Student, with this our chapter 1 we have completed. We will see you in the next part, new video. Thank you, students. Maintain the classwork and homework note neatly with good presentation. Thank you, students.